Hey, you, I need you to hit the subscribe button below.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
Let me get Isaiah 30:8, because we out here trying to lift up our people, trying to get them out smoking, trying to get them out drinking, trying to get them out pouring out our daughters and sisters. Bro. What's up, my brother?
Hey, Curtis.
Curtis. All right, Curtis, listen to this and then we're gonna get into your history. You believe in the Bible?
Tell me what you told me, Kirk.
I'm Muslim.
Okay.
So I read the Quran.
Okay, you believe in the Quran.
I feel the Quran is a confirmation of the truth that's still in the Bible.
Yeah. Hey, somebody give me from Babylon at Timbuktu. Oh, somebody. All right, listen to this real quick. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 30 and verse 8.
Uh-huh.
Now go, write it before them in a table,
yeah,
and know it in a book.
Come on.
That it may be before the time to come.
So this is talking about our people. Listen up, read.
Forever and ever.
Uh-huh.
That this is a rebellious people.
We are rebellious. We are rebellious to the Most High God. Curtis, stay with me now. Stay with me now. You got 5 minutes. Okay, we're gonna hit on that. This is what we need to understand, because what does Quran mean?
Quran means
what does the name Quran, what does that mean? Recitation.
Yeah.
It's the recitation. What were they reciting? I'm gonna show you. Read.
From Babylon to Timbuktu by Rudolph R. Windsor.
Islam and Judaism. It's the topic. Read.
The Prophet Muhammad adopted many principles.
He adopted what?
Many principles.
Read.
And laws from the Jewish religion.
From what?
From the Jewish religion.
That's why y'all don't eat pork. That's where y'all get praying towards Mecca, because initially they were praying towards Jerusalem. That's what we do. Okay? Read.
First of all, the basic idea of monotheism.
Why? Because before Muhammad's time, the Arabs of that day, who were they praying to? Do you know? They were praying to all the idols, right? They had an idol each day of the week, okay? But Muhammad was well acquainted with the Jewish laws, the scriptures, our book, your book, not the Quran, all right? And then he said, you know what? I like this. I like this a concept of a one God, one true living God. I like this concept of praying towards your land. I like this concept of not eating unclean things. I like this concept of keeping our sisters modest. All right, read it again.
The Prophet Muhammad adopted many principles and laws from the Jewish religion.
Uh-huh.
First of all, the basic idea of monotheism.
Monotheism, read.
Which is the belief in one God.
Read it, skip down.
Muhammad adopted also the main idea of the Jewish calendar, the Day of Atonement.
The Day of Atonement is where we fast to get remittance or repentance for our sins. We get forgiven of our sins. What holiday mimics that in Islam? Where do y'all fast? That's Ramadan.
The Sabbath must
Sabbath? When is y'all Sabbath?
Sabbath day.
Uh-huh. When
it, day
it's, y'all started on Friday, right? We that ours starts Friday at sundown. You understand? We got that out the Bible. Read on.
Much of the Bible.
Much of the what?
Much of the Bible.
The Bible, front to back, New Testament, Old Testament. Read.
And the narratives.
And the narratives.
The narratives from the Medrash.
Medrash. Yep.
And many points of the ritual law.
Ritual law. Again, getting into those things that I already discussed. Read on.
Incidentally, the Jews pray three times a day facing the city of Jerusalem.
Uh-huh.
And the Muslims, true believers, pray five times a day facing the city of Mecca.
That's where he got it from. Again, we pray three times a day, morning, noon, and evening, right, towards Jerusalem. Initially, they did the same thing. However, he was doing that to try and convert Jews at the time. Not Jewish people, the Jews. It didn't work. Okay, listen while you walk off, because this is very important information. History is not the Quran, it's in the scripture.
Right.
All right? We were never supposed to be Muslim. We were never supposed to be Islamic.
Right.
Those people took us into slavery. Now, go ahead.
Trying his best. Muhammad sought to convert the Jews.
He sought to convert the who?
The Jews.
The so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, according to the Bible.
Right. To his new religion.
To his new religion. His new religion, Islam.
Read. But to no avail.
It didn't work because our people at the time couldn't be tricked into believing in other idols at that time.
Read. The Jews were adamant and resisted to change.
Because we knew who our God was. Give me that in Psalms 96 and verse 5. Because today we have no idea who our true God is. We have no idea who our true salvation is. Why? Because we've been fooled. We've been led into all these other different religions to think, let us think that that's the way. We need to follow Buddha. We need to follow Islam. We need to follow Caesar Borgia and Christianity. None of those are according to the Most High God in his scriptures. Read that.
The book of Psalms, chapter 96 and verse 4.
Uh-huh.
For the Lord is great and greatly to be praised.
The Most High God is great above all, and he's greatly to be praised. That's what we're doing out here by bringing out his word. Read.
He is to be feared above all God.
Because he is the only God that has any power on the face of this earth.
Right.
The things that happen in our streets nowadays, when you see what happens to people like Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, give me some more, George Floyd. All these things are of the Most High God. Allah didn't do these things.
Right.
Buddha didn't do these things. The Easter Bunny didn't do these things. These things are of our God and our God only. Keep reading.
For all gods,
read.
Of the nations.
Of the other nations, so name one. You can name any god. If they're not the god of this Bible, what are they?
Our idols.
They're idols, meaning they're a vain, dumb thing. They don't have anything to do with us, and they have no power on this earth. Read.
But the Lord made the heavens.
The Most High God is the creator of all the earth, and he is in control. The world is in his hand. He is the ultimate power on earth.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.